everyone's seen that Friends bit, isn't it, where Chandler says, oh, I've got a nubbin, and everyone's like, what is that? And then once I just looked down, and I was like, wait a second, I've got one of them. And I went to the doctor, and I was like, what is this? And he said, that it is the third nipple, and apparently 1 in 10 people have them. Anyway, the answer to that was that we both went to the same prep school, which was Hill House.
Oh, did you go on Friends Reunited?
What was my face used to promote in Las Vegas without my permission?
Is it panty pads?
No.
No.
Was it the Bellagio's All You Can Eat buffet?
Mm.
It is. It is the best buffet.
It is.
Real thick. It was a $50 discount on VIP nude shows. Okay, next question. I wrote a song called Alfie, which is all about my brother. In that video, what embarrassing situation did I show him in?
Having a wank.
Correct, Amanda.
It wasn't just any wank. It was a special wank. It was an M&S wank.
Actually, last time I saw you, you were escorting me to the loo, weren't you?
I am a part-time toilet attendant.
Did you give her a lollipop?
Yeah. Romance.
Take a look at this house charter I wrote when I was 8 years old. These were the rules that I decided everyone in our house should abide by. I've blanked out some of the words in one rule, and all you've got to do is fill in the blanks. Don't use or touch blank, blank, without permission.
My third nipple.
No.
Is it possessions?
Yes, it is. Contest is Alan! Wearing the coat on your behalf is the second evictee from the Big Brother house. It's Shawnee! I'm good, thank you. Do you want to put your coat on?
What?
Shawnee, are you up to this?
Have they got any choice?
3, 2, 1, go! After the break, it's a chance for anyone, anywhere, to ask me anything. See you in a bit. Project. I'm Lily Allen, and I'm very happy to be joined by the lovely Justin Lee Collins and Alan Carr.
How are you doing, Lily?
I'm a bit scared, actually. I'm a bit nervous.
We're not making you nervous, are we?
A little bit.
Is it the sheer animal magnetism emanating?
It's funny you should say that. That's exactly what it is.
Yeah, we have that effect. We tend to find that. It's just a lot of man coming right at you.
A lot of women don't feel safe,
so much
do they?
Yeah.
We're testosteroning all over you.
Yeah.
I'm so completely off.
I think I'm just going to go and have a wash.
Lily, you performed at Glastonbury last weekend. How was it?
Doing Glastonbury was amazing. Definitely the highlight of my life so far. I cried when I came off stage. It was amazing. It was like my whole life had been building up to that point, and I'm fucked if I know what I'm going to do now.
Last time festival I went to, my friend got me this tent. And it was her tent, honestly, the most phallic tent you've ever seen. It had like a bell-end pelmet. And of course, everyone, it's over 10, and I'm coming out, and I'm going, oh, look, it's Alan, typical, look at his 10, have a day off, do you know what I mean? And I'm like, it's not 10, do you know what I mean? And then the thing is, when it got cold at night, how weird is this? It started raining, it went flaccid, honestly.
Now it's time for Ask Me Anything.
This is the part of the show where anyone, anywhere can ask Lily Allen literally anything. So let's start with a question here in the studio. What was your question, love?
You've written some pretty harsh lyrics about your ex-boyfriends. Did any of them complain?
Yes. Quite simply, they did. I had actually, one was watching my show at Glastonbury this weekend while I sang that song, Not Big, and I don't think he was very pleased. I think all his friends found it quite amusing watching.
So I used to go out with Lily Allen, yeah, this one's from my boyfriend. And you know, imagine that.
This one's for you, Spunky Pants. Yeah. Okay, we've also got a question from a close family friend of yours. It's none other than Mr. Harry Enfield.
Aww. Hello, Lily. One of your most popular songs is Alfie, based on your little brother. One of my most popular characters is Kevin the Teenager, based on your big sister. What's it like having two siblings who've both achieved national popularity by having the piss taken out of them?
You lived with Kevin the Teenager?
Yeah.
What was that like?
Oh, come on.
It wasn't very... I mean, I love my sister now, but at the time it wasn't about, not really very fun. You know, like the little babies that run around beating each other up?
Yeah.
That Harry Enfield does a sketch of. That's me and Alfie. Lulu, I'm the one with the blanket, and Alfie's the one that gets beaten up by me.
You used to beat up poor Alfie?
Yeah, he's younger than me. And he couldn't speak.
That's not
a very nice older sister.
Okay, let's take another question. Put your hands up in the air. What's your name, love?
Sophie Mason, you write loads of songs about your exes and sort of try and get back at them. Did any exes get back at you for any reason, and what did they do?
Oh, you know what? Actually, my ex-boyfriend who I wrote Smile about went to the tabloids and sold his story for lots of money, which was really nice, about our romping in the forest, which my grandparents really appreciated. That wasn't very nice.
How weird is that? Something like Smile and they sue, and yet you call someone this premature ejaculating needle dick and he just goes... What are you talking about?
Alison is currently on the other side of the Atlantic working tonight, but she still wanted to ask you a question. So here's your mum.
As I am halfway across the world in Los Angeles, I think it would be a good idea if we used this show as a little bit of a therapy session. And I wondered if there was anything you'd like to confess to.
I'll tell you what, I'll tell you something I did to Alfie when I was younger. Does anyone remember that really nice purple cowpole when you were a kid? Yes. It was delicious, wasn't it? And I drank a whole bottle of it, and my mum walked into the living room. She was like, right, where's this gone? And Alfie couldn't talk yet. And I just looked at him and went, he did it. Wait, before he even got rushed to hospital and had his stomach pumped.
Keep your hands up. There's a chap with a blue shirt sat on the second tier. Hello, what was your name, mate?
Kenny.
What's your question, Kenny? Oh, here we go. Easy, Ken.
Who will you go out with me? Yeah.
What was your most embarrassing moment and why?
Most embarrassing moment? Oh, I think I really fancied this guy when I was about sort of 17, and I shagged him. And then left his house the next day and couldn't find my pants. And as I was kind of leaving and out of the front door, he was kind of like gave me a kiss on my cheek and I just saw them poking out the edge of my trousers. And I was too embarrassed to kind of like get down and pick them up, so I just kind of walked out. So he must have found my dirty pants in his hand.
Thanks, got a special guest in the audience. It's the lady who I believe is responsible for you singing.
Really?
Yes. Rachel Santesso, is it? Where is Rachel? Miss Santesso, could you stand up, please? So Rachel is your old music teacher, is that right?
Rachel discovered me, really. When I was a kid, I was about... Well, you can tell the story, Rachel.
Lily was known to be quite a difficult student at the school. But I only knew her as quite a sweet girl. One day I heard her singing on her own. She was singing Oasis, Wonderwall. And this beautiful voice came out. And I told her to come in at lunchtime for singing lessons. And I got her to sing a song from Dumbo.